There are many of us here this weekend that are reminded that our mothers aren't here right now to give us a hug. My mom's been gone almost 11 years, and there's still days when I want to call her up and ask her a question. And I literally pick up my cell phone, and then I remember I can't call her. That's when I'm so glad I have the Holy Spirit. That's when I go back to my quiet place. And in my mind's eye, lay down in the room. Now, to be perfectly honest with you, when I think of that now as an adult, there were things crawling on the ground there. I wouldn't be laying down on the grass like that anymore. But it was a good place to be. Jesus is telling them, let not your hearts be troubled. He was warning them, it's about to get really scary, really quick. They were already afraid. They were already hiding. They knew that Jesus' triumphal entry into Jerusalem was his death sentence. They knew that because he rode in the king's gate on a colt, was proclaiming that he was the king, not Caesar. And Rome had a really dim view of people claiming to be the king instead of Caesar. And the penalty for insurrection was death. And it was death on a cross. Now I want you to think a moment about this, because Jesus has asked to be the king of your life. To whom do you owe your allegiance? To Christ or the world? Which way do you go? Do you run with the Comforter who is with us always? Or do you want to continue the ways of the world that lead to brokenness, betrayal, and death? I think some of the most powerful words Jesus ever said was, but don't be afraid, I've overcome the world. One of the best lines I heard at my continuing education was that there will always be powers and principalities, but the Prince of Peace has conquered them all. We live in a now and yet not now. We live in that time in between. One last thought for you. In the War of 1812, quick, when was the war? Oh, good. Okay. The British wanted their colony back. And the colony, which had become the United States of America, did not want to give their government back. They wanted to stay a sovereign nation. And so there was a war fought. And the British lost again. 2 for 2. another member. He didn't leave us as orphans. He's coming to us in the Spirit and is with us forever. Amen.